I've never seen anything like this before. Sanitary seat cover. So different. Hey y'all, so I'm currently in New Orleans, but I'm waiting on my friend because my flight, like this flight was really the best option. There was only two flights I could choose from, either this early flight or a late flight. At least if I like wait on her, then we won't miss any of the stuff that we have planned. But if I had came later, then we would have been missing an event or something. So I'm just gonna chill here and edit and just, you know, talk on the phone with my friends and wait until she arrives. So yes, this is my hectic morning. I still have not ate anything yet, but I'm just kind of like saving my appetite because we're gonna eat a lot. But all right, yeah, I'll check in with y'all later. She brought the Miami to New Orleans. I'm so happy.
Hello, hello, hello.
Why? That's for all. Y'all, we getting ready right now in the airport and don't care.
I like
it. Me as well. Y'all, look at how bougie this looks. Sorry if y'all saw a titty. But the views though. This is my bathroom, by the way.
I'm not supposed to walk.
So we're about to put our lashes on and then we're gonna get an Uber to our brunch spot. But okay, I'm gonna update y'all later. Cause I hear somebody coming. Y'all see the product?
Yeah. Yeah. You know I'm here at the video shoot with my grandson, you understand me? He ain't got to have a gun, you understand me? He constantly getting bigger, you understand me? The yee-hee, nigga!
Okay, we're out at brunch. We're at Beer Cat. They have a lot of vegan options, so if you're a vegan, check them out. And I'm gonna show you guys my plate when it comes out. It's called the Breakfast Club. And for my drink, I got a mango lemonade because mango is my favorite. So I'm so excited to eat, y'all. Alright, we got the potatoes and the ketchup. They seasoned the fuck out of these ones. You got potatoes too?
They do.
Let's see. You know, they said I was gonna have avocado. Where that's at? It's in my sandwich. I love that if they put it in the sandwich. I know, I love that. Yes. This reminds me of what I used to make for breakfast, so they have bacon in it. Yeah.
You love solid beans, like the bus.
Yeah. This is the sweet line. Yeah, 7th floor. We got the sweet line. I don't even know what you would call this, luggage pusher. Yeah.
Luggage,
hey girl.
I know.
What? Ooh, okay. A little desk area. Ooh, that's a mirror that I done bumped into. You know what I'm saying? Boom. Then we walk in, we got the bed for us. Gotta look at the aesthetic. Little phone. Okay. Look, TV. What is this?
A bathroom.
Oh, okay. Okay, Shelly. Come on in here, Sue.
Okay.
Come on.
gonna put my bag to.
I'm about to change, so this is my little video. I like a baby. Don't be playing me. So yeah, we finna head to the aquarium. This the fit. It's what it's giving. You got nature and water.
Let me get a video.
We got earth and water elements going on here.
Going to the aquarium. Giving very much angelic.
Yeah.
What's your mood? Pick a character. Pick an avatar. Pick a vibe. I think you're getting like Kim Kardashian cozy.
Yes, I'm giving Skims. Yes, there you go. Bomb. That's all it needed. Yeah.
I'm a water sign, like this is where I'm. Look at the stingray! Oh, girl, you are. That's big. Anything I said, I stand on it. In a private lane, I land on it. Billy Hood and they call me Bankole. Cause I walk around with a bank on me. Show them Gangnam style, put the gang on them. Twist my fingers up, I'm bang on them. Billy Hood, oh yeah. Nobody know tomorrow. Choro kaju. And if a boy feel macho, make him leak red like a tomato. If him not dead, then him comatose. Go for me. Wow. Oh my gosh. Hi, painters. They look fake, but they're real.
That's the red-tailed hawk.
No, don't play India. Because if he fly over here, what you gonna do?
But like, I'm scared of fish. Like, you know when you go to the ocean, there's like those small little fish that come up. I don't like those. I don't like those. I don't. So, no.
He's scary. Imagine me swimming with these motherfuckers.
I think I would
turn up
with like, I would do this, like, if we both go in there, I would do it.
And if I knew that, like, it's guaranteed that they don't bite or anything like that, you know?
Y'all hear the birds, they acting out. But right now, we're on the riverfront. We just finished the aquarium walk.
It's such a beautiful day out.
So happy to be here, taking a moment, be in the present. Take a moment, be grateful. It's only day one. Like,
so we're waiting for our ferry ride. It starts in about 15 minutes. And
tried to go in this casino. Why they actually adhere to their rules, talking about we gotta be 21. Okay. I just wanted to go in there for the vibes. It's just manifesting. We got our first drink. We drinking that Cali, you know what I'm saying? Hold on, I gotta take this down.
Don't mind my one last time.
They ain't even noticed, dude. It's a bitch. What's up, vlog? So we about to go to, we trying to go get some food, okay? We finna hope that this place will let us sit. But if not, we finna go to Bourbon Street and try to get some drinks or find something to eat, cause baby. I'm about to order our Lyft and I will check in with y'all and let y'all know how our night goes. Right now it's 10 p.m. by the way. So we finna go to Bourbon Street and hope that we find food. I don't want to get drunk and not eat, so we'll see how that goes. Y'all, the lashes is off. Let me tell y'all what happened on Bourbon Street in Louisiana, in the Lou. Me and my girl had went out there. Y'all seen we had left here at like 10 something. Cause we was trying to figure out what we was gonna eat. Yes, I'm a little bit intoxicated. That comes with the territory. Anyways, so went ahead, we Ubered to Bourbon Street. So we get to Bourbon Street and as soon as we get there, like, you know, there's a police car blocking off all the traffic, so like the whole street is just pedestrians. Like, we're able to just walk in the streets, the sidewalk, everything's crazy. The music, there's clubs, there's food, there's people dancing in the street. It's just, it's lit, okay? You know, we feeling the vibes. We see these people with these drinks, like we want to get one of those. So we was trying to figure out, like asking random people, like, where'd you get that. Somebody told us the name of a place. We're walking towards it, but you know, as we're walking there, there's a whole bunch of other stuff going on. Like, it's a whole bunch of distractions. Finally, we found this place that sold it, and it also had wings. So we stopped there, we get wings. You know, we're feeling the vibes. Everything, it was looking up. One of the things that we noticed was there was these women who would show their titties, and the people on the second floor, they would just throw beads. They would throw beads at the women, you know, whatever, and you know, that would be like their little incentive. And like, you know, it goes along with the culture, I guess, or Mardi Gras, whatever. I don't know, y'all. Inform me if y'all know about the history of New Orleans and why the fuck is that linked to showing your titties. Just seeing more wild stuff, you know, people getting drunk in the streets. Boom, that's when this lady comes up to us and she has like a little tray of shots. They look like test tubes, different colors. She comes up to me and her and she was like, y'all ladies, take a shot. Like, y'all want a shot, take a shot. And we was like, nah. Like, I first said no because I already have this big drink. Me and India both have these big drinks. So we was like, no, like, we're good. Then she was like, she basically was trying to like coax us into it.
And she was like, you sure? And I was like, she could take one, like, you know, we not driving, like, she could take one. And she, like, India looked at me, and then India looked back at the lady, and the next thing you know, the lady just throws it in her mouth. So then that's when I realized, I'm like, well, shit, my friend just drank it. Like, I don't want her to drink it, and I didn't drink it. Like, let's just be on the same page. So I was like, I'll take it too. Like, it's fine. I'll take the shot too. She throw it in my mouth. The next thing I know, right after I finished tasting this nasty ass liquor, here she go talking about some, that's gonna be $50. Excuse me? Bro, I literally shit myself right there on Bourbon Street. Cause what? I was like, $50? Talking about $25 for two shots. And like, I was like trying to ask her what kind of liquor is it. I'm like, is that vodka? Is that tequila? She's like, it's a whole bunch of different rums. Y'all, is rum expensive? Cause I'm confused. We're just sitting there like, okay, well, I don't have, me personally, I was like, what's your payment method? Cause obviously, like, I can tell, okay, this is her hustle. If we don't pay her, she's gonna be upset or she's gonna throw a fit, and we're already drunk and I just don't really feel like dealing with it. So I was like, what's your payment method? She said Cash App, and I don't have Cash App. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna Zelle India my half, which was $25, and let India Cash App her $50. So we sit in there and India starts Cash Apping into her, but like the whole time, like, I'm right here next to India and the lady's in front of us. So India's like holding her phone to an angle, and I see her put her phone on airplane mode as she bought the Cash App lady. So right behind us, the lady, she's there, like a different lady doing the same hustle. She cursing out a lady next to us, and she was like, oh, you only got $10. Like, no, you owe me. Like, I'm finna get the police and I'll fight. Like, I'll fight you, da da da, and all this. I don't even know. I can't even recall very well.
Well, you know, you have to pay. Yeah, some of us don't have it. And I got Cash App. So you know, baby. You know, baby.
Call the police when you doing some illegal ass shit.
How you finna say, oh, we finna fight? Like,
if you gonna fight, you gonna fight. You're not gonna say we finna fight. No cap. Like, everything she was saying,
punch me in my face or something like that.
Everything that she was saying, like, okay, it just sounded like she was just trying to threaten her and scare her. You know what I'm saying? Because the girl who's selling the shots herself was probably drunk. Like, they all seemed out of it. So I'm just like, and then that's going on right beside us. So the lady who is, I guess, her coworker or their partners or whatever, she's listening to that and, like, you know, she hearing her turn up. And I just feel like that adds fuel to the fire, you know, like, now she see her partner turning up. So if we don't pay her, she gonna turn up too. So she go talk about some whatever you did.
It's just two versus one. We should have just been like, fuck that.
Bro, like, she was like, whatever you did, because she realizing that the money not coming through. And like, she was like, whatever you just put your phone on, like, turn it off, like, send me my money, da da da. And chop. So we just there like, fuck.
I need to learn how to request my motherfucking money back from Cash App.
Yes, if you got her name still, request that shit back. After we, the money ended up going through to her because, you know, India was like, fuck it, I'm just gonna take it off of airplane mode, whatever. So it went ahead and went through. And, you know, honestly, like, because we stood there with her about 5 minutes trying to, like, you know, send the money. And I'm just there like, this lady is blowing.
There you go, baby. All
right. All right. Bitch, I was recording that whole thing because why the fuck we just got scaled?
For real.
Bitch, fuck.
Did you hear what I tried to do though?
Yes, bitch. I wasn't going to say shit.
Bro, I'm not going to lie. I'm feeling it.
Me too.
You're not feeling it?
I feel it.
Bro.
She
threw it.
Bro, I should have said no. Never again. I swear to God, we got to be. Hell no.
I said no more fucking money.
At the fuck all, bitch. I'm so sorry. Because what? $25 for two. I'm done. Like, okay, now looking back at it, of course, we should have never took drinks from a stranger. Yeah, reporter. We should have never took drinks from a stranger. That's off rip. But it was just like, you know, we were in the setting, we're in the city. We didn't let that stop us. I mean, yeah, we were baffled, but, you know, we were still having a good time. We walking around and, you know, we found these little clubs to walk into. We just, you know, enjoying the times. Then the second and last thing that happened where we were like, all right, it's time for us to leave Bourbon Street. So we were passing by these people. We've been seeing these people that had big ass boa snakes. Okay, maybe it's not a boa snake, I don't know. But it was like, you know, wrapped around their neck, and we're like, oh, but me personally, I'm not a snake person. So I was like, oh, from afar. So then that's when we passed by them a second time, and Indy was like, no cap, like while we're here, like, cause the two jokes that we kept making was we should just flash our titties for some beads. And then she was like, bro, we should just, you know, put the snake around our neck, cause fuck it, we in New Orleans. So I was like, I'm straight off of that. We're standing like on the corner, and then like across the corner, like the opposite corner from us, is the snake people. There's about four of them, and all of them have different snakes on their neck. So, you know, India was thinking about it. So she went up to one of the guys and she was like, how much would it be, you know, like, and like, is it free basically? Because I was like, there's no way that we learned from our experiences that nothing here is free. Like they ain't doing this shit to be cute. Like they want money. So what's the call it? She's like, how much? He was like, $20. So I was like, I feel like it's just money. It's just money getting thrown. Like, it's not worth it. Let's go. So she was thinking about it, you know, thinking about it. And then she asked the next girl, because she was there. She was trying to figure out if all they pressed was the same. So she goes up to the girl. She's like, yo, how much would it be? She was like, $20. She's like, they don't buy it, trying to convince her. Because she came back to me. She's like, talking to me. She's like, should I? I'm like, if you want to, YOLO, you know what I'm saying? YOLO, like, if that's what you want to do, girl, I'm straight. I'll be from over here. I'll take your picture. The other guy was overhearing us, or I don't know, but we weren't talking to him, now that I think about it. And I don't know why he jumped back into the conversation. But here he come with his big ass boa, and he go and he try to put it on India. Like, he's like holding it up like this. And like, that thing is, the tongue is hissing. I don't like that shit. So I'm trying to back away. I'm like, fuck no, fuck no, fuck no. And India's running from him. And he's literally like, it's not a big deal. I don't know what he was saying, but he was just like holding it up, like coming towards her. And I'm like, chill. Like, what's wrong with you? What are you doing? And then all the commotion going on in the street, because there's people still walking through. Like, it's a whole lot going on. My wallet falls, and like, India's still running from the guy. The guy is still chasing her with the fucking snake. And I'm like, my wallet. I look and I literally see a guy pick up my wallet. Oh, pick up my wallet? So I was like, that's mine. I swear, especially because I got liquor in my system. I was loud as hell. That's mine. I'm snatching it from him. That's mine. He's like, oh, I wasn't going to take it. I know that's yours. I'm going to bring it to you. Yeah, right. Yeah, fucking right. Don't touch my shit. I don't trust none one of y'all out here. Give him a shit. And that's when, you know, I made sure Indy was right next to me, and we just took off. I was like, yeah, no, it's over. It's over for the NOLA. It's over for Bourbon Street. It's time to go. And that was it. That was the end of the story. And that's what happened on our first night in the NOLA. So my advice to you is, you come here, just take care of yourself. Make sure you have a friend with you. Stay vigilant. Keep your head on a swivel. And don't talk to none of these strangers, because they don't have your best interests. Like, everybody out here is just trying to make money, for real. I went to New York and it was a similar vibe. Like, you'll think that they're just trying to entertain you, or like, you know, make sure that you have a good time as a tourist. But no, baby, like, this is their everyday scam. They come out here every weekend and do the same show, and they run off on your check. So just be careful. Don't be quick to spend your money. This was not a waste of money, because it was a t-shirt for $5, and I can wear this to bed, and it's a memory of New Orleans. So yeah. But other than that, big Bourbon Street, be careful.
Bless you.
It's tiny. Y'all, we about to dip. We're finna go get some food, some breakfast. It's a beautiful day out, and they said it was gonna rain. Hi. I totally forgot to show y'all my food, but I'm already starting to eat. It's a little side salad with a smoked turkey sandwich with greens.
Shots forced on me and a snake. Somebody try to force a snake on me.
And I got a Nutella banana nut bread.
It's only really my good. Third day out here.
Second day. And then the turmeric tea, because I'm trying to make sure I don't get sick and I want to stay healed up. So yeah. You can put that on anything I said I stand on it. In a private lane, I land on it. Hollywood and they call me Bankoli. Cause I walk around with a bank on me. Shoot them and I'm style, put that gang on the lily. They weren't ready anymore. They weren't ready. I'm just going to put the selfies in college. They weren't ready.
Look at it. Yum. Yum.
Y'all, we're gonna go to the swamp toe. This the drip, little surf drip. You know what I'm saying? Get into it, y'all. Get into it, y'all. So our Uber is on the way, and I'm excited to see what this is gonna be. It's a pretty long drive, though. Get into it.
Fuck a bitch, I don't trust no bitch with my government. Fuck a friend, I don't want no friends with no open hands. Count my bands all alone at home. Don't you call my phone. Everyone that I ever known ask me for a loan. Leave me alone, 44 Stallone. Get the nigga gone. Raging boy, this not paid in full, but I kill my own. Yes, I love you cause you black, but don't love your ass like that. I will put you on a shirt if you fuck me out my racks. Cherry app, down the app, hold you ass. Average. Louis bag, Gucci bag, you got baggage. I will never give my money to a bad bitch. I will never give my money to a bad bitch. Derry Ave, Locust Ave, ho, you average. Birkin bag, Chloe bag, you got baggage. You will never catch me slipping out in traffic. You will never catch me slipping out in traffic. AMGs and SMGs.
I got mac and cheese. It's called cashew mac and cheese. I got okra gumbo with white rice, collard greens, sweet potatoes, and Creole curry with white rice.
We are about to go to the art district, check out the museum, see what the scene is like. And then we're gonna go get some dinner at Mediterranean place.
Comment down below if you think I sound like I'm from New Orleans.
Okay. Baby, don't talk crazy.
Cause I know what I'm talking about.
Right, precisely. So I'll check in with y'all when we get to our destination. You know what I'm saying? See you later, baby.
So we about to go to
brunch slash breakfast at a jazz themed place with a band and all. I'm so excited. Our last little hurrah before the airport. Our lift is outside. We about to head downstairs. And so
it's
our plan.
Birthday.
Yeah.
It's my birthday.
Exactly. She's wearing an extravagant. She's wearing an extravagant dress. So I feel like they're going to like definitely like how they going to question us. Yeah. So we're going to be like, it's her birthday and see how they treat us, girl. They said this is vegan, period.
And sweet potato, rum, and peanut butter.
Okay, we're about to leave to head to the airport. It's been great, Moxie. You guys were an amazing hotel. I am at the airport. It's been a great trip, man.
Well, I'm tired. I'm gonna sleep on that plane. This was a must, apparently. My last stop while I'm here, we're gonna try a beignet. I'm such a tourist. Oh wow, just a whole bunch of powder. I missed my flight, so I'm on the next flight. And I have to stop in Houston, and then I'll be in Tampa. Just a little update. I had a mental breakdown. I cried in front of the lady. Yeah, it was a lot, but I'm okay now because I have beignets. This thing powdery. I'm gonna get it all over my black. How do people do this? I'm gonna get it all over my shirt. It's literally like a powdered donut. I don't know why it's so hyped up. These are hyped up for no reason. Unpopular opinion. I mean, I get it's the culture, but it's never that deep.
Down in Houston. Look who's here. How did that happen?
Oh, okay.
Try that again.
So I just arrived safely in Tampa. Thank you guys so much for watching to the end. I know that this vlog is probably going to be pretty long, so if you made it to this part, thank you so much for tuning into my journey. This was a fun vacation. I had so much fun. The only thing that really messed it up was like the travel, like with Spirit at the beginning, and then when I missed my flight, that really had me stressed out. Like I literally had a whole breakdown off camera. I literally cried in front of the Southwest people, like, but I had to realize that, you know what, it's okay, I'm gonna make it home regardless. Like, they put me on a flight, I didn't get charged for missing my flight, so it's a-okay. Very grateful for my experience, very grateful for my friend. She really planned everything for us. She did all the research and picked all those places to go. She is just amazing, and I'm just so blessed. So I'm gonna close the video off here. I hope that you guys enjoyed, and if you did, make sure you like, comment down below, and let me know what your favorite part of the vlog was, and you subscribe for more content because it's on the way. Okay, bye. I'll talk to y'all next time. Peace.